Welcome back, everybody. Time for What's Hot. We're going to talk about the stories that have us all talking.
We're joined by Tracy Johnson from Tempo Milwaukee, and Jeff Wagner is back. Topic number one, we've been focusing on domestic violence. Yesterday marked the one-year anniversary of the Ozana Spa shooting. More than one in three women in the U.S. will experience physical violence, rape, or stalking in their lifetime. And now, in light of this case, there's a renewed push for universal background checks on gun purchases. What are your thoughts?
Well, I think... Look, I don't have a problem in general with background checks, but I think if you're going to talk about domestic violence, you need to talk about other things as well. You talk to the prosecutors, and they'll tell you one of the biggest problems they have is that they bring the case, and then the woman ends up going back with the abuser, and she won't cooperate and things like that. I think you have to let the system work, and I think there needs to be a lot of intervention. Again, telling people that it's okay. You don't have to be a victim. Let the system work, but sometimes the victims need to help out in that regard.
Well, and I applaud what WTMJ is doing by having this phone bank, allowing people to call and to talk about things that are going on, people that they know. All of this awareness, I think, is a good thing because it allows people to see that if you don't speak up, that something can happen. Now, the universal gun checks, there are lots of reasons that you would or would not want that, but I'm not sure, you know, connecting it to the domestic violence is necessarily, I don't see the exact correlation. Except,
well, Jeff, a year ago, after a gun was bought through a loophole and used in the Ozana salon shooting, you said there needed to be an adult conversation and that change would probably come from that. Looking back on that, here we are a year later. Did we even have an adult conversation over the last year, or were people just shouting over each other?
Well, I think it's probably the latter. I mean, I think this when it comes to the whole issue of gun control, it's just very, very divisive. And I don't know that you're going to get a consensus, which is why I think sometimes you need to move beyond the instrumentality, in this case the firearm, and start talking about like these other things. What can we do to get people into the system? Because the truth is, you know, even with a background check, if you're denied the legal right to buy the gun, if you want to buy the gun, you're going to go out and get one on the black market. I just think there's other stuff you can do.
Well, and think about all of the abuse and the violence that occurs without a gun. That's just one piece of the puzzle. I mean, think about the number of suicides because of this abuse. Think about the number of just physical abuse and bruising. You know, so there's a lot more here. I like your thought about the adult conversation and to get women to speak up, to know that there's help because there's a lot of help.
Not be afraid.
Coming up, we'll talk more about domestic violence and the effects it can have on children. We'll also reveal our viewer's choice topic of the day.
Viewer's choice topic of the day.
Again, we're joined by Tracy Johnson and our old pal, Jeff Wagner. Parents discipline their children in different ways. A new study suggests that spanking could lead to aggression in children. It shows that young kids acted out more, were more aggressive when they had been spanked. Do you believe that 1 + 1 = 2 here?
I actually think that there's a lot to be said for this study. Before I had children, I didn't think very much of the people that said, oh, I'm just going to give my kid a timeout, or I'm just going to tell them that they're naughty. But I can actually see it. If I spank my little boy, you know, he'll turn around and he'll hit back. And I do believe that there is something to it. So
I think
the kid hits back.
He'll try to hit back, and I think that it fosters itself, and the more that you know, try to use spanking as that deterrent, it just doesn't connect with the end result that you actually want to have happen.
So, never once, I was spanked on occasion, did I think about hitting back. You did not do that.
Well, I don't know.
See, I think there's a difference between spanking a child and beating a child. Mm-hmm. I think it depends on how you approach the thing. Obviously, for small children, sometimes they just don't understand no. They don't understand timeouts. The kid is reaching for the hot stove. You can say no, but they don't appreciate that. So maybe that slap on the hand, that gets their attention. Now, there is a difference. If you start hitting your child out of anger and repeatedly, or you start using outside instrumentalities, that's different. So I think it all depends. There's spanking isn't the same for every parent.
Well, you see a lot of times, and there are parents out there that believe that putting their kid across their lap and whapping them is the way that they're going to get them to change their behavior. And I think there is a lot to be said for this study because I do think it leads to aggression.
Oh, okay, your child throws a fit in the grocery store aisle. You know,
just yes.
They're screaming, won't get up, screaming. You can't reason with him. Are you going to slap him on the wrist or slap him, swat him on the behind?
No, I'm going to pick him up and I'm going to leave the store. I mean, it's a pain in the rear for me, but that's what I have to do as a parent. Hitting him isn't going to do any good except make him cry even louder. And believe me, I have tried. But I think that you have to do what's best for the kid at that very time. And it might be a pain in the butt for you. But
all right, out of time for What's Hot Today. The discussion will continue online. It's at tmj4.com/hot. When you hear the phrase domestic violence, it often